Welcome to the Application Delivery How-To Video Series. My name is Surbhi Paul. Today, we are going to cover the topic of how to use enterprise-grade ingress and load balancing for Kubernetes. So let's begin. I want to talk about ingress services for Kubernetes. Under the covers, there's a lot of details behind these ingress services. You have to secure your communications across applications and also have to connect your services together. You often don't just have Kubernetes in your infrastructure. You have Kubernetes as perhaps a new project in your enterprise, and you also have a lot of other applications. So what VMware offers as a portfolio is the ability to connect, secure, and observe all your services across whatever form factor or cloud you choose to deploy. Fundamentally, there are three aspects to it: traffic management, security, from what users are doing, what are their access patterns, and finally, it is about observing the performance, observing security from accountability point of view, and then end-to-end transaction logging. How we can observe and apply some of these principles to provide the right SLO for your applications. Let's discuss some of the key challenges with ingress services for Kubernetes. Today, platform teams have to stitch together disparate functions such as layer 4 load balancers, layer 7 ingress, DNS IPAM to connect to external services, GSLB for multi-site, multi-cluster connectivity, and WAF to secure the ingress. Customers have a choice of cobbling up a solution using point products. Let's take load balancer as an example. This needs to connect to other network that exists in your infrastructure, and this needs to be tied together to DNS. You need layer 4 for some and layer 7 for others. These applications need to be secured and examined at layer 7. Finally, if you have multiple data centers and you require DR or multi-site, multi-cluster app deployment, then you need a global load balancer. So it's a non-trivial problem with all these challenges, right? It presents complex operations. It's difficult to manage and troubleshoot with independent components. And when you take a look at these multiple point products, they don't offer full analytics. They offer no end-to-end visibility. And user ends up compromising between feature and cloud-native automation and scale. Now, success of a production deployment, you know, it depends on how easy it is to operationalize, and customer experience is compromised because of app availability, performance, responsiveness, network observability, simplified management. And these are exactly where load balancer and ingress can help and being addressed by Avi, which is modern, proven, and tested. How does Avi help address these challenges? Avi is a single hop that does all the ingress functions. So it is not administrative efficiency, but also data plane efficiency. Avi has made it very simple and automated, both from administrative and consumption point of view. So let's first talk about operator point of view. So imagine a service that combines a load balancer, ingress, DNS, global service load balancer, WAF, and other security that you need, combined with world-class observability, all integrated into a single product. Fully automated, that can be deployed, performs full cycle, life cycle management, elasticity and capacity management, high reliability, works in any environment, in the data center or in your cloud. So that makes the management, deployment, and operationalization of all services easy for the operator. Now, from developer point of view, you know that things don't change at all. You still consume Kubernetes. You are still creating native objects, whether they are ingress or a server. So it provides a very simple automated experience, both for admins deploying the solutions and also for developers who consume the solutions. And a big part of that is made possible by the architecture that Avi brings. Let's take a look at it next. And we'll wrap it up with that. So let's look at what are the aspects of the architecture that lends itself to the modern applications. At a high level, this is also a cloud-native architecture. The controller is the orchestrator that provides all these services. Then there are these workhorses, these proxies called service engines that are deployed in your environment, and they actually provide services like load balancing, GSLB, ingress, and so on. The controller completely orchestrates and lifecycle manages these service engines, connects it to the right network, performs intelligent placement, provides elasticity regardless of what environment it runs in, VM, container, or bare metal. So the whole experience is quite automated. It's set up and monitored. You can go off and do other things while system pulls together a lot of automated tasks needed depending on the environment. That's it. Thanks for watching. Please check out our other exciting videos in our Application Delivery How-To series. Thank you.